this paper.
No, sorry. The main goal is to improve from knowledge of the explanatory processes of narrative persuasion in the field of communication, using data of obtained in a study of the time education based on audiovisual fiction. Our theoretical background is of course narrative persuasion. Narrative persuasion model applied to entertainment education intervention in the field of health communication. I am going to speak about the TV series Revelador de todas posiciones. This is a TV series produced in Colombia. And I am going to present an empirical study, specifically an experimental research with 2008 participants. In this study, we performed a mediation analysis to understand the process or the mechanisms that can explain the impact of these TV series revelados. Well, what is narrative persuasion? When we are talking about narrative persuasion, we are approaching to this topic trying to understand how exposure to fictional narratives designed to entertain can cause persuasive effects. Like, for example, this is the like a movie, Philadelphia, in relation to ice, for example. In this case, narratives, as such television series or movies, are processed differently from traditional persuasive messages, such as commercial advertising. There are important differences between traditional persuasive messages and narratives. Firstly, persuasive narratives usually contain a list of arguments in an explicit way, because they are trying to sell something. Secondly, show a clear attitudinal goal. The goal of the message is to change attitudes. On the other hand, narratives try to illustrate through the presentation of events. Action is focused on the main characters and their behavior and their attitudes, and they are designated for enjoyment. Also, there are clear differences between the processing goal in one case and in the other. With respect to persuasive messages, the processing goal is to develop a correct attitude from the audience point of view. On the other hand, the processing goal involves in narratives is related to involvement with the story and with the characters. In this sense, has been proposed several theoretical models to try to understand how persuasion works in the context of traditional persuasion and how persuasion works when we are trying to understand the impact of narratives. In the main process in dual models, for example, ELM by Petit-Cassiopo, is the process called cognitive elaboration, that in one word is reflection, and issue relevant thought that audience develops during the processing of a message. On the other hand, the main processes of narrative persuasion are transportation. This is a good image of transportation, the story engage the audience, and identification with the characters, in which empathy is an important process. In this specific research, we are trying to understand the specific role of identification with the characters. In this context, identification with character is an imaginative process that involves a temporary replacement or arms identity with that of the character from an affective and cognitive point of view. There are three different dimensions that explain this concept: emotional empathy, cognitive empathy, and merging, a temporal loss of self-identity. Narrative persuasion models applied to health communication, there are in fact two theoretical models, extended elaboration likelihood model, entertainment overcomer resistance model. Both of them propose that identification reduce counter arguing, and for this reason messages are assimilated with no resistance. When a person feels a high degree of identification with the character, it's very difficult for this person to reflect during the processing of the narrative. And this is the mechanism that would explain narrative persuasion. So, this is theory, but in fact, empirical research into these topics isn't early stages and has some, moreover, contradictory findings. In the context of TV series that usually are employed in entertainment, education, intervention, on the other hand, we can see that usually in this kind of fictional narratives, they are designed with a clear educational component. It's very different from the typical movie, entertainment movie. In this case, a TV series used to be used in an intervention, in entertainment education intervention, has a very clear component. This means that even though narrative format didn't explicitly present arguments, these arguments can be present in the dialogues taking place among characters during certain moments of the story. For this reason, we can propose two possible relationships between identification with a character and cognitive processes. Firstly, identification, because the empathy dimension, can stimulate involvement with the story, with the character, which in turn may increase the elaboration of the messages, that is, increase reflection, issue relevant thoughts. On the other hand, we can also propose that identification, which is also related to a temporary loss of self-identity, would lead to a less critical reading of the message. So there are two possibilities. Identification can increase reflection, or identification could increase decrease counter-arguing. So for my objective in this research, I am going to present now, is to tell to what extent the attitudinal impact can be explained because identification leads to a greater reflection, or on the other hand, rather to a greater counter-arguing. Counter-arguing is a critical processing of a message. This is our mediation models, in which you can see in the slide that there is two mediating variables, cognitive elaboration and counter-arguing. Both are connected in a sequence. You can find here the independent variable, identification with protagonist, and the dependent variable, attitudinal measure. The method. In this research, 2008 participants had to watch only one episode o revelado desde todas las posiciones. Participants were randomly assigned to three different groups. In each group, people had to watch one different episode. And you can see the episodes in this internet website, YouTube. And after viewing the episodes, people had to complete to fill in a questionnaire containing several skills to measure perception processes and attitudinal impact. Revelador desde todas posiciones is a TV series produced by Fundación Imaginario in Colombia. The first season had 20 episodes, lasting about 15 minutes, and the main characters always are Camila, Juan Carlos, Vanessa, and Sebastián. Here are the episodes that we use in the present research. Episode 8 was focused on adolescent sexuality, trying to reinforce a positive belief, belief about sexual decision making. And Camila was the main character of the episode, transmitting the educational message. Episode 10 was focused on gender violence. The idea was to reinforce a negative attitude towards gender violence. And Vanessa was the main character transmitting the educational message. And finally, episode 17 was focused on sexual diversity, and the idea was to reinforce a positive attitude toward gay men who decide to openly express their sexual orientation. Juan Carlos, in this case, is the main character transmitting the educational mission. You can see both of the episodes on YouTube, of course. The questionnaire was administered at the end, immediately after subjects viewed each episode. And this questionnaire contained several scales to measure identification with the four characters, to measure cognitive elaboration, the degree of reflection during processing the narrative, to measure contrariety, to measure resistant or critical or a critical approach to the message, and finally several measures to understand, to evaluate attitudinal impact. Well, we use a specific program, a specific macro developed by Hayes for the statistical program SPSS. This macro is called Process, and this macro is very, very useful because permits to perform a mediation analysis, in this case with two mediating variables operating in a sequence, in this case cognitive elaboration and counter-argument. With this macro, process macro, we can perform, obtain information about the indirect effect from identification through attitudes mediating or explained by the two mediating variables, cognitive elaboration and counter-argument. And here you can see the results. I have performed one mediation model per each chapter, because each chapter of episode has a different focus: sexual diversity, gender violence, or the sexual decision making. In this case, you can see that we found a statistical significant indirect effect. So, identification with Camila was associated with more cognitive elaboration, and this in turn was associated with a more positive attitude towards exile decision making. Counter-arguing didn't play a significant mediating role. The same pattern of result we can find in the this slide. You can see this slide. This is the chapter episode 10, focus on gender violence. Again, we found a statistical significant immediate effect. So identification with Vanessa was associated with more cognitive elaboration, and this in turn was associated with a more negative attitude toward gender violence. Again, counter-arguing didn't play a significant mediating role. And finally, with respect to episode 17, focus on diversity sexuality, we found again a statistical significant indirect effect. So, identification with the main character, Juan Carlos, was associated with more cognitive elaboration, and this in fact, this in turn was associated with more positive attitude toward women coming out. Again, counter-arguing didn't play a significant role. So, the study confirmed the important role of identification with the character as a mechanism of narrative persuasion. In this case, a greater identification with the main character was associated with a greater cognitive elaboration, reflection, issue relevant thought, in turn leading to prosocial or preventive attitudes. In the three cases analyzed, counter-arguing didn't play a significant mediator role. So, from the theoretical point of view, this means that the models of narrative persuasion and the dual model of rhetorical persuasion may be compatible in certain contexts, specifically when the fiction are designed with character presented explicit arguments about prevention in the dialogues. By the way, this TV series, Revelador de todas las posiciones, has been selected to be presented in the next Japan Prize 2014, that is going to be in Tokyo. The TV series was selected because the quality and also because the innovation in the way to address education through fiction. And that's all. Thank you very much for your attention.